Like, I'm not going just switch up because the cards is down. You get what I'm saying? I stand. Huh?
This nigga,
like, he broke
every code
and
every
rule
out this motherfucker, bro. He's an ungrateful
rat
bastard, man. That's just that
simple,
man. But I forgive the little nigga
after
all. Like, you know what I mean? It's all good.
Yeah, man. I get you, man. I lie to you. I think about everybody in there. You know what I mean? Everybody, my nigga. Like, it ain't cool. You get what I'm saying? Like, a lot of niggas is dragging you from it. A lot of niggas is standing with you still. You get what I mean? A lot of niggas don't know what's going on. You get what I'm saying? And that's another reason why I spoke up, because they got to have a balance of the narrative.
Thanks. Yeah, that's a fact, bro.
How's your vibe?
I appreciate
nah, man, bro, I promise you, bro. Like, it's not even, it wasn't even to be appreciated. It was
man,
to just be.
My team ain't dead, man. Trey Lee is not dead, man. A rat nine, a bitch nine, whatever that nigga want to call himself nowadays, man. What he did. Trey Lee still staying strong, bro. I want that to be known, man. Like, please, that was
fair. Do you?
Nigga, I'm about to get sentenced, and I'm about to cop out, bro. So, like, I'm telling you, like, I'm about to take some time, like, you feel me? Taking my time so nobody can't tell me, you know, none of that shit that he made it for rap for no reason. Like, you chose for no reason, nigga. After old catch on with this nigga's shoulders, you fucked up your own name for no reason, because the night you said against me, it's gonna be you. Cool. And I stand on my own. Like, yeah, I did this and I did that. Thank you, Yana, give me my time. You get what I'm saying? I'm cool with that, bro. But whatever that nigga said, he just fucked up his career. So that's what I want the world to know. You get what I'm saying, bro? I can talk, nigga. Like, I can talk, bro. You feel me? I can talk, bro. Like, nigga, rat bastard. Like, I can talk, bro. Trust me when I tell you that, bro. I can talk, bro. You know what I'm saying? Whenever you're ready, we put something together. Right now, nigga, just trying to situate.
Check it out. So, a lot of people are asking me, they say, yo, Ack, man, what do you think about this whole thing? Shotty just pled guilty. And by the way, Shotty just had, like, his own, like, phone interview with, like, the 6ix9ine's old DJ, which, by the way, 6ix9ine's old DJ, DJ Punch, basically says, I ain't fucking with 6ix9ine and how he's moving, and if he's snitching, I can't fuck with him, period, okay? Now, a lot of people have been saying, is 6ix9ine snitching? Now, we've seen, like, of course, the plea deal, which basically when 6ix9ine went in court to prove or plead that he's guilty and take a guilty plea, a part of that admission and what the prosecutor expects is that 6ix9ine will be able to testify against any and everybody who goes to trial. What does that mean? Pretty much, if y'all niggas about to go to trial, 6ix9ine gonna be pointing right at y'all for anything y'all did when he was around. Okay? Now, when Shotty took actually a plea, right, of guilty for a couple of charges, and he's gonna get at least 15 years. Why did he take it second after 6ix9ine took it first? Probably because 6ix9ine would know the most about him over everybody else. The closest person to 6ix9ine out of everybody charged was Shotty. So pretty much, if you go to trial, 6ix9ine is going to be pointing at you for most of the shit if he has to testify. Now, here's the thing. Because, you know, there's a lot of schools of thinking. As you hear Shotty say, yo, he's an ungrateful rap bastard. You know, I've heard people say this, right? Let's start off with this. Because, you know, people say, yo, 6ix9ine is the reason why all these niggas are in this situation. And I do look at this situation as so tragic and unfortunate. And 6ix9ine isn't without blame. You know, he's a grown man who made decisions that jeopardized his life, his safety, his kids' life, their safety, his friends, his crew, their life, their safety. But I also have to say that the other men who have been charged with 6ix9ine in incidents that had to do with 6ix9ine or had to do with beefs he caused or beefs he like pretty much like escalated, those men should have made a gut call early. Okay? There's certain niggas, if you're really friends with people, you know certain niggas who you could actually bring to the shootout, and some niggas you could probably only tell about it the day after. Not everybody's gonna stand tall. Not everybody's about that life. Y'all basically, and I'm talking to all the other people who co-signed 6ix9ine, y'all co-signed that he was about it, not acknowledging the fact that when it came down to it in a situation like this, to be honest, most people on the outside looking in, it's saying he's doing right now what we thought he would do. Okay? Now, that don't excuse 6ix9ine, right? Of course, you got to look at 6ix9ine and be like, damn, dog, you tell me that for your career, you basically had men do all this shit to make your image look good, and you basically treat them like brothers and whatever, whatever, and of course, a lot of them weren't rich before you, and, You know, the money may have influenced them to do dumb shit even though they're grown, and now you're throwing them to the wolves and you're just trying to skate out clean. That is weak as well. Now, it's up to you how you want to look at things. You know, there's a going, it's like an ongoing propaganda, it seems at this point, where some people are saying, yo, that nigga could tell, okay? There's nothing wrong with telling if niggas fucked your baby mamas, if niggas actually, like, try to kill you, and niggas is robbing you. And it depends on where your morals and how you view street life and view just street activity in regards to those things. Now, again, if you ask me, personally, because you're probably saying, Ak, you've been around, you've met Shotty, you've met 6ix9ine, what's up with them? Shotty, in my opinion, I never had any bad relations with. He always seems like a really cool guy. He always seemed like he was down to put himself in front of every person. He seemed like he was a person that, listen, he would most likely go on a suicide mission to protect somebody else, right? However, I don't know him completely. I never got involved in their business affairs. Was he stealing money? Nigga, I don't know. That's something that 6ix9ine would know, something that his accountant would know, maybe a lawyer, and Shotty. Now, let's address what Shotty's saying in terms of 6ix9ine is an ungrateful rap bastard. Now, when Shotty most famously said in court, we don't bend, we don't fold, we don't break, it's fucking Treyway, it was a sign and probably sending a signal to 6ix9ine to say, we're not taking deals. When 6ix9ine take a deal, it's basically the straw that's breaking the camel's back. Other niggas gotta take deals. Niggas gonna be taking decades because of probably that action. Now, I'm not saying everybody indicted, but everybody who was close and around 6ix9ine when some of these incidents happened. So you gotta look at that, and we really won't know until 6ix9ine gets out, whenever he gets out, when he could actually stand up and say, yo, I did these things, and yes, it's in paperwork that he is cooperating. What cooperation means to you could mean a bunch of different things, but it did include and might end up being testifying if he gets that far. Now, as I said, it's up to everybody to make their own conclusions. I think Shotty has to speak on more things in depth, you know, because if he's accused of doing certain things, some people are going to excuse 6ix9ine. If he is telling, I think 6ix9ine got to speak up whenever he gets free or he could about why he's doing what he's doing, because a lot of people are confused and say, damn, if these were your guys, you screamed training for a whole year, why would you ever isolate yourself from them when you get locked up, basically days before, like say fuck them, and basically seem like you're playing on the opposite side of the field and you're only thinking about yourself. So when you hear Shotty say he's an ungrateful rap bastard, you have to take that with, listen, it holds a lot of weight because this is how shit is playing out, but you have to hear everybody's sides before you make up your opinion. Again, hopefully we'll hear more from Shotty, hopefully we'll hear more from 6ix9ine, and hopefully for everybody who's interested, you can figure out who's doing what's what, and basically how you feel on the matter, all right? Get a cop, Maximus, you guys like them, subscribe to Woods Academics.